Sing a song, make it simple to last your whole life long. Don't worry that it's not good enough for anyone else to hear. Just sing a song.
Welcome to show number 5 of Let Your Heart Sing, here on World Radio, KHOE, 90.5 FM in Fairfield, Iowa. I'm Sheila Moschen, and I'll be your host. Most Let Your Heart Sing shows are now available on YouTube and on letyourheartsing.org. On today's show, Ken Barrett will tell us how he came to write his song, The Paradise Cafe. And we'll hear other uplifting songs, some by local musicians. We'll start with Let Your Heart Sing, sung by Katharine, McPhee.
With a whisper, a sound on the breeze, dancing on the moonbeams and shaking the trees. From one single note to a chorus it done, it grows like your hope from the moment it's born. Flying over rainbows on the promise of tomorrow, let the truth save the day, and you'll never
you didn't know that was from the movie Tinkerbell. We're here with Ken Barrett today, and he's going to tell us how he wrote this really happy song called The Paradise Cafe. So welcome, Ken.
Thank you. Thank you.
Can you tell us a little bit about your musical background?
Yes, I picked up a guitar when I was 17 and started teaching myself, and spent long hours teaching myself in the days of no internet and no YouTube and so forth. And that's really where it started. And I was always interested in music in the 60s, you know, the Beatles and the Stones, and particularly Bob Dylan, Leonard Cohen, Paul Simon, the songwriters, you know, the real songwriters. So that they and others, like Neil Young and others, have been my influence. But that's my background, mainly playing acoustic guitar and doing folk music sort of things.
Did you ever take guitar lessons?
No, I think I've had 5 lessons.
Really?
Because yeah,
you're very good.
Oh, thank you.
I mean, I heard you play many, many songs, some of your original songs, including Paradise Cafe, and yeah. I was very impressed.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah,
thank you.
And your voice goes along very nicely, too. So tell us some about the Paradise Cafe, that song that's so happy and upbeat, and what inspired you to write that song?
Well, it's interesting, actually, because it's sort of got a country flavor,
yes.
Which is not my style of music at all. I don't really like country music, but because it was a song about Iowa, I mean, I couldn't avoid it.
Right.
it came about because I was back in Australia. I'd been here in Fairfield for a few months, and the Cafe Paradiso asked me to be the featured artist at the open mic, which I did. That was significant for me because it was really my first real public performance ever. So except for a few open mics at the Cafe Paradiso. And I was thinking about that and how much I enjoyed it and how much the audience seemed to enjoy it. And the song just started, and it started in that, you know, I was coming into Fairfield and so forth. And then, yeah, it just grew from there. And it grew, it was about Cafe Paradiso. That's what I thought it was about, but apparently nature had different ideas because it expanded out from that to be about Fairfield and MUM and consciousness and a little bit of Nyaya in there, and so it was interesting to watch that happening through me rather than happening from me.
What grabbed my attention was when I heard "Find the music in the gaps between the sounds."
Mm.
I really like that reference.
Yeah, I really like it too. I wonder where it came from. It's very good. I, as all songwriters know, you know, the songs come through you. You don't really. It's very difficult to write a song, you know. But it's not very difficult to be there and let the song be written through you.
Right.
When it comes.
Okay. Well, thank you very much for being with us, Ken. And now we're going to hear this really happy song called The Paradise Cafe.
I was rolling in from Burlington, IA, on Highway 34. I was heading for the Paradise Cafe. I'd been there once before. On the radio, the pines were tuning in. My feet were tapping on the floor. And I was dreaming of the songs that I would sing. And then I dreamed some more. I dreamed a dream of the silver singing string. I dreamed a dream of golden light, and I was dreaming of the happiness they'd bring as I drove into the night. The mist was rising as I came into the town, light was shining from the door. I was heading for the Cafe of Renown, what I came here for. It's enough to put a smile upon your face, enough to make you stay. It'll hold you in the warmth of its embrace, the Paradise Cafe. There the angels gather just to give you rest, it's there the angels play. There's a girl there with a goddess on her chest, in the Paradise Cafe. She sings with honesty enough to make you weep. She fills the night with stars. And as she sings, you know you want to be. The Isaac to her Rebecca. We found the music in the gaps between the sound. We found the silence in our soul. We were lifted by the scepter and the crown, and both were made of gold. Her eyes were shining with a joy that was complete as I turned another page. It was time for me to get out of my seat, so I stepped up to the stage. It's enough to put a smile upon your face, enough to make you stay. It'll hold you in the warmth of its embrace, Paradise Cafe. It's enough to put a smile upon your face, enough to make you stay. It'll hold you in the warmth of its embrace, Paradise Cafe. Paradise Cafe. Paradise Cafe.
Now we'll hear Emily Levin's beautiful song with her beautiful voice called Generation to Generation. In 2006, filmmaker David Lynch published a book called Catching the Big Fish, in which he describes the creative benefits he has gained from his practice of the Transcendental Meditation Technique. Right after reading his book, I was inspired to write this song I call Catching the Big Fish. I also created a video for it, which you can find on YouTube under Sheila's Tunes. Catching the big fish is easy to do. Just close your eyes and dive inside. It's waiting for you. An ocean of consciousness is deep down within. Just settle to that quiet place where all thoughts begin. Capture ideas where they originate. Just grab a chair and close the eyes and then meditate. Transcendental meditation is the key to unlocking inner genius and creativity. It's easy to do. Catching the big fish is easy to do. Just close your eyes and dive inside. It's waiting for you. Infinite intelligence is inside everyone. This ocean of solutions is where great thoughts come from. Whatever we put our attention on grows. Just turn the mind from out to in and pure knowledge flows. When we transcend space and time, we enliven natural law in cosmic mind. It's inside of you. Water the root to enjoy the fruit, settle the body and mind. The answers we seek are inside down deep, in silence we meet the divine. Catching the big fish is easy to do. Just close your eyes and dive inside, it's waiting for you. TM reveals our inner wakefulness. It gives deep rest and energy and dissolves all stress. Bliss is the nature of pure consciousness. Wake it up and bring it out for true happiness. When you transcend activity, you open your awareness to all possibilities and become more you. Catching the big fish is easy to do. Just close your eyes and dive inside and dreams will come true. Next is a slow song about consciousness by Kirtana called I Am.
Before the body, before the story, before the name, beyond the mind, attempt to find or explain. Before the breath, beyond the sense of pleasure or of pain, and after death, I am. Within the heart, the whole and part of everything I see, behind the eyes, beyond disguise, reflecting me, at the silent core, and yet before phenomena began. Oh, and after it, and after it, I am. Many differences separate us on the surface, yes. But I cannot find a boundary consciousness. ask me, where does awareness begin and does it end? I have to say, I've always been. Within the body, without the body, not subject to changing moods or states of health or points of view. Without needs, before the deeds and the monuments of man. Oh, and after them, I am. Many differences separate us on the surface, yes. But I cannot find a boundary in consciousness. And when you ask me, where does awareness begin and does it end? I have to say, I've always been. The silent core, and yet before phenomena began. Oh, and after it, I
Now we'll anchor our show with a male voice singing a touching song called How I Love This Day. Brad Moses was inspired to write this song from a spiritual experience he had as a little boy. He was looking up at the sky and feeling at one with everything. The sky was so huge and he was feeling so enormous and was wondering how all this could fit into his head. Brad wrote and performs all the parts to this music, including the vocals, instruments, lyrics, recording, etc. This is one of many new songs Brad has recently written and recorded, which will be coming out soon.
I remember when I was just a kid, looking up at the enormous sky. Somehow it all fit in my tiny head, and I felt as big inside. Now all around me, life is flowing, a world of wonder without questions why. There is something all-knowing, glowing, and I feel like I could fly. Yeah, I feel like I could fly. How I love this day, and how life tumbles down inside. Beside me, how I love this day. Bop bop ba doo, bop 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 ba doo, bop 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 ba doo, yeah. Was it a drop of rain, or a flick of sunlight, or maybe us
simply holding hands. Some gentle shift and everything turns golden bright. It's the heart that understands and awakened this sweet romance. How I love this day and how life bubbles up within me and the way you're always here in me. How I love.
Thank you, Brad, and thank you, Ken Barrett, for joining us today on Let Your Heart Sing here on World Radio, KHOE, 90.5 FM in Fairfield, Iowa. And remember, you can find most Let Your Heart Sing shows now on YouTube and on letyourheartsing.org. Have a fabulous day.
Just sing a song.
Just sing.
Just sing.